Hello friends, welcome to Digimento Education. So today we are going to discuss a very, very important bill, a draft policy which has been released by the government of Delhi. So it is the electric vehicles policy of 2020. We will be discussing today in detail about the electric vehicles policy 2020 of the Delhi government. Now before that, we need to know some background about this policy. What is the reason or rationale behind this policy? The simple reason is that those people living in Delhi or those people who have at least visited Delhi once, especially in winter, must be knowing about the quality of air in Delhi. Especially in the last few years, the quality of air in Delhi has deteriorated too much that people are not even able to breathe, leading to many diseases relating to the lungs. So in this background, the government of Delhi has released this draft policy, which is the electric vehicles policy of 2020, of which we will have a look at in this lecture. So let's begin. But before that, this is our channel, and if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe to this channel and share this video with your friends if you like it. If you are preparing for GATE, NTA, UGC NET or for PGT Computer Science, please do visit our website to know the details of the online courses that we provide. So this is our website and this is the contact number through which you can get more information about the courses that we provide to you. Let's come to the details of electric vehicles policy of 2020. So it is the government of Delhi, which has released this electric vehicles policy of 2020. Now let's look into the details. Emphasis has been given on replacement of two-wheelers. So replacement, that is replacing the two-wheelers, public transportation, shared vehicles. Public transportation means the public buses and the other public mode of transportation. Then shared vehicles like the shared auto, rickshaw, etc. The goods carriers, etc. Instead of private four-wheelers with electric vehicles. So all these two-wheelers, public transportation, shared vehicles, those goods carriers, so all these will be replaced with that of electric vehicles or the EVs. So this is the plan of this policy. Now moving further ahead, let's see what is an electric vehicle. So EVs or the electric vehicles, it is the one which uses one or more electric motors or traction motors for propulsion. So the electric vehicle uses one or more electric motors or traction motors for propulsion. It is powered through self-contained battery, solar panels, that means the use of renewable energy, solar energy or renewable energy, or an electric generator to convert fuel into electricity. So the electric vehicles are powered by self-contained battery, solar panels or electric generator, which helps in converting the fuel into electricity. There are different types of electric vehicles. It includes fully electric vehicles and hybrid electric vehicles. Fully electric vehicles means completely it uses electricity. And hybrid electric vehicles means which uses an electric motor plus a combustion engine, which is a combination of combustion engine and an electric motor. So electric motor uses the electric energy, whereas the combustion engine, it uses the fuel for combustion. So this is briefly about the electric vehicles. Now coming to the features of this bill. First one is the replacement of existing auto rickshaws and state-run buses, that is the public buses, with e-autos and e-buses. So auto rickshaws, in the first phase, the auto rickshaws and also the state-run buses or the public buses will be replaced with e-autos, electric autos or electric buses respectively. Secondly, it will ensure delivery-based services operating in the city powered by e-mobility. So it will offer or ensure delivery based services operating in the city. So all these are powered by e-mobility. Now what are the examples of delivery based services? Like example is Uber Eats. Then there are Swiggy, Zomato, then Amazon. So all these are delivery based services. So Amazon, Flipkart, Myntra. So all these are examples of delivery based services. Once you order something online, it is delivered to you. So delivery based services which are operating in the city, it will be powered by e-mobility. So for delivering those services, the electric vehicles will become compulsory. Then again, increasing the road tax for fuel based vehicles. So road tax will be increased for fuel based vehicles. So here also, this is a kind of disincentive to the fuel based vehicles. So this will definitely reduce the number of fuel based vehicles on the road. And scrapping incentive, this is another feature of the scheme or the policy, that the scrapping incentive will be provided for those people who want to switch. So those people who are already having a vehicle, whether it is a car or a bike, any two-wheeler, three-wheeler or four-wheelers. So those who already have a vehicle, for those who want to switch to the new one, that is to a e-vehicle, a scrapping incentive, that is they have to scrap their old vehicle or they have to sell it off. So a scrapping incentive will be given for those who are already possessing a vehicle and those who want to switch to the e-vehicle. So this is the another feature of this particular draft policy. And the government has also decided to offer low interest rate loans. So loans will be given, credit will be given at low rates of interest to people to buy commercial electric vehicles. So for people to buy the commercial electric vehicles, the government has decided to give low interest rate loans. And the government also has decided to offer subsidies and road tax and registration fee waivers. So waivers, that is, will be provided with subsidies, then waivers in road tax and waivers also in the registration fee. Also very important is that a state electronic vehicle fund, a state electric vehicle board and a dedicated EV cell will be constituted. So these are the new things. That is, one will be an electronic vehicles fund at the state level. Second is a state electric vehicle board. And third is the dedicated electronic vehicle cell. So all these will be constituted at the state level. Now, why do we need EVs or electric vehicles? What is the significance of electric vehicles? One, as we discussed in the introduction of this lecture, this will help in reducing the air pollution, the pollution levels, especially in the Delhi city, in the city limits. Second one, this is more affordable, accessible, inclusive and safe mobility. And thirdly is that the right coordination among the three pillars of EV, that is EV industry's three pillars. One is urban planning, second is transportation, third is the power sector. So by this policy, this will help in right coordination among the three important stakeholders or three pillars of the electronic vehicles industry. And this will also provide a push to the Make in India initiative. Make in India initiative is to encourage manufacturing within the country to promote the domestic capacity to manufacture and to export commodities. So these are the importance of this electronic vehicles and this particular policy. So this is all about it, the policy and also about the electronic vehicles and the need for electronic vehicles in brief. I'll meet you again with a different topic. Please do subscribe to our channel if you haven't, and also press the bell icon and also do share this video with your friends. Thank you.